Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to our NBA video for Tuesday, November 23rd. I'm a little late today. I was up working on something and I was watching Narcos Mexico. And definitely didn't go out on a bang like Narcos Mexico season 1 and 2, but I'll take it. I'll take it. Last night, I haven't been playing many lineups because I've just been dealing with other things. But my main FanDuel lineup, I put up a 292. Definitely wasn't good enough for the contest I was in. I had Mitchell, Maxey, Patty Mills, Korkmaz, Michael Mulder. I don't know what possessed me to take Michael Mulder, but I won't do it again. He had a whopping 12 fantasy points. Jared Allen, who I knew was going to do good, he had 41, Durant 54, Drummond 51. So, I just missed cashing by a few points. Top dude in the slate, he had Lonzo, DeJounte Murray, Garland, Giddey, Hart, Niang, Horford, Sengun, Drummond. Horford, Garland, and Ball were popping for me the whole day. The only thing with Horford is that Robert Williams, he played. So I didn't want to play Horford with Robert Williams in. So that's what got me off of him. The whole SGA news, you know, that had me altering my lineup. But it is what it is. That I had Curry in my lineup the whole night. I had Curry in my lineup. Didn't even realize he was out. Had to hurry and get him out the lineup. Once you got Curry out the lineup after right before lock, there wasn't really much places you could go to to switch it up. So you had to eat pie or eat shit, whichever one you had to do. But it's no big deal though. No big deal. It happens. Alright, so we got a 4-game slate. I already went through this slate because, like I said, I've been working on something. And we're definitely going to need value for this slate because the way it's set up now, not looking too good. So just a little quick message. My Patreon is up and running, and my Patreon is going to be more for people that, you know, the hardcore players that want that last lineup right before lock, after all the starting lineups are up and, you know, somebody's ruled out and last minute changes. So my Patreon is geared towards that. So in that Patreon, you're going to get a graph. You're going to get a graph, and it's going to show you exactly what's happening. So you got Luka playing, DK projected for 56.3 fantasy points, FanDuel 52.7. Minutes expected 33. Luka's fantasy points per minute 1.37 fantasy points per minute. Salary on DK 11.7. Salary on FanDuel 10.7. Is he starting? Yes. Value on DK 4.8. Value on FanDuel 4.9. His usage 35.79%. Westbrook 49.8 on DK, 46.9 FanDuel, 33 minutes. Westbrook's at a 1.08 fantasy point per minute. His salary 10.5 on DK, 9,900 on FanDuel. Obviously he's starting. His value on DK and FanDuel is 4.7 each, respectfully. His usage is a 29.14%. If you're new to NBA DFS and you don't know how to read usage or you don't know what it means, you can use Luka as a baseline. 35.79 is one of the highest in the league. So 29.14 is also high. Reggie Jackson, 24.94. So that's how you get to gauge it. Lillard, 28.9. These guys always have the ball in their hand. So these are going to be pretty high. So that's what usage is. Lillard, 46.5. FanDuel, 44.2. Minutes expected to play, 38. Fantasy points per minute, 1.21. Salary on DK, 9,600. FanDuel, 8,800. Is he starting? Yes. Value on DK, 4.8. 5 times on FanDuel, and his usage is 28.9. So we're doing this for point guard, shooting guard, small forward, power forward, and centers. And these are going to be my player pools of the players that I deem good plays and good value. So this is going to be included in Patreon every day, and it's updated throughout the day. So as people are ruled out and, you know, bench players are starting and they look better, they'll be added. So that's just a little glimpse of what's going to be in the Patreon. Okay, let's get to this. Luka, 11-7, as you've seen earlier. He's a good play today. Little pricey, because I'm looking for 6 times value, but Luka is 11-7 going against Cleveland, the Clippers. Westbrook, 10-5, without Braun, he's going to be a good play. He actually might be a must play, but right now we're going to leave him at a good play. Lillard, 9,600, good price. I'm expecting him to play a little bit better. What has he done last 4 games? 41, 47, 47, and 56. I definitely like Lillard. I definitely like Lillard against Denver. I actually have him projected for Lillard 46 on DK and 44.2 on FanDuel. So at 9-6, he's a good play. McCollum is a 4-game slate. McCollum is a good play. Lowry, 7-7. Against Detroit, he's going to be able to do whatever he wants. Kyle Lowry is a good play at 7,700. Cunningham, I expected Cunningham to be 7,500. He's 7,400. Cade Cunningham is still, this is still too cheap for him, because his upside is, sky's the limit for his upside. Especially wait till he starts hitting the shots. Last 4 games, 51, 41, 46, and 50. Tyler Hero is in my player pool also. Price is fine, 7,300 against Detroit. Definitely also a good play. Brunson, I'm not on Brunson. I'm not on Brunson if Luka's playing. I'm on Reggie Jackson at his price, 6,100, second in usage. And anything below him, I'm not really on. You know, RJ Barrett's okay, you don't know what you're gonna get. Bledsoe's a good play. He's decent. Kemba Walker, no. Derrick Rose, no. These guys split points, split minutes. You don't know who's gonna play what. So I'm good. Monte Morris, is an okay play. Terrence Mann, not for me. Last three times I played him, he played me, so I'm good on that. Corey Joseph, if he starts, we'll see. But right now, I'm not really on them. It is a four-game slate, so you're going to have to play somebody, so we'll see. Will Barton, 7,400, decent price, 3,200. I have him projected for 35.8 fantasy points. He's going to give you 34 minutes. He's a 0.99 fantasy point per minute. That's actually like a 1. So he's a 1 point per minute player. He's going to give you almost 5 times value. And his usage is at a 21.94. So if you're confused by this chart, these are like advanced stats. So, you know, regular DFS players will understand the chart. If you're a beginner, you don't understand the chart. Reach out to me in chat, DM me, Instagram, Twitter, and I'll help you out. But that's more for seasoned players. You don't want to be, you know, filling your head up with too much stuff. You gotta get the basic stuff first, and then you can go on to all that other stuff. But, you know, just letting you know there's levels to this game. Like I said, you want to make sure they can pay off their salary. You want to make sure they're playing, you know, 28 minutes and up. And then, you know, you want to make sure that the game that they're in is going to be a close game. The other day I said I didn't want to play Orlando because they were going to get smashed by Milwaukee again. And what happened? They got smashed by Milwaukee again. See, listen, I know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying? Listen, if you play DFS, you're not going to win every night. But they're bad plays and they're correct plays. Except for certain bench players on these bad teams. For example, like RJ Hampton, who you knew Orlando was going to get benched, and the bench players were going to have to play most of the minutes. That's a decent play. You never know how these games are going to go with these bad teams, but you know, not playing Orlando last night was the correct play. If you want to know what I mean by correct play, pull up any of your sport apps, check the box score for the starters on Orlando against Milwaukee, for the first game against Milwaukee and the second game against Milwaukee. And that's the difference between bad plays and correct plays. If you're going to play a team knowing they're outmatched, how do you expect your player to play mid-30s and minutes to get 15-20 shots and give you a lot of fantasy points to win contests if the team is going to get smashed off the floor? You know, that's the reason I pick who I pick. That's the reason my player pool is the way that it is. And that's the reason that I try to explain to you guys the different details, the different things you need to look at when you're picking players. You know, just because somebody is ruled out doesn't mean the next man up automatically is a smash spot. Especially on these bad teams like Detroit and Orlando. You know, when you're playing fantasy, you want to try to get a game where you know it might be close. Denver and Portland might be close. If Luka's playing, Dallas and Clippers should be competitive. Miami and Detroit, are they going to be competitive? Maybe not, but you hope so. You know, if you play Jeremy Grant today, against Miami, and they get smashed out the arena. You think he's gonna play his full run in the fourth quarter? Probably not. Are you gonna need that to score your fantasy points? Most likely, yes. That's just an example of what I'm trying to, you know, what I'm trying to explain, what I'm trying to express. But shooting guard Cunningham in my player pool, Barton in my player pool, Hero 7-3, always a good play. Brunson only if Luka's not playing. THT maybe today with no LeBron, he might be in play, but he's still 6,000. You need 30 fantasy points to talk. You need 36 if you want to win a contest. I may update him and put him on my player pool, but I'll give him a yes. He's okay. Hardaway Jr. with no Luka, he's in play if Luka's not playing. Bledsoe, last man in, I'll take it. Duncan Robinson, no. Alec Burks against LA. Alec Burks is in play because, you know, the Lakers like letting people shoot lights out on them. So Alec Burks is absolutely in play, especially at 4,200. Malik Monk, he's not in play for me with THT back because THT does play in the blowout run. That's about it for me. That's about it for me for shooting guard, small forward. Paul George, 10-3, always playable. Jimmy Butler, 9-7, playable, even against Detroit. You're looking for like 48 fantasy points. Sadiq Bey against Miami, 6,000. Last man in kind of situation, he's okay. You need 36 fantasy points. Michael Porter Jr., my player for the year. God bless his soul. RJ Barrett, you know what? Now I think about it, because they're playing the Lakers, I might put him in the player pool. He might be viable. Everybody's viable against the Lakers. Norman Powell, 5,000. Not really viable, but I mean, he's viable, but he's a regular play, nothing spectacular. Luke Kennard, I'm good. Finney Smith, if Luka doesn't play, he's okay. Evan Fournier, 4,000 against the Lakers. All I'm gonna say is there's a reason he's $4,000. On to power forward. AD is always in play. Play him. Randall is in play, but if AD is only $900 more, you play AD. Porzingis, if Luka's not playing, then he becomes viable. If not, I'm not playing him. I'm not going to play him with AD and Paul George on the slate. So you can't play all three of them. Jeremy Grant, 7,000. You need about 42 fantasy points against Miami. If you think they're going to keep the game close, go ahead and play him. Aaron Gordon, I never play him, but hey, you can do what you like. 6,700. You're going to need, I'll tell you right now. You're going to need 40.2 fantasy points from Aaron Gordon. If you think you're going to get that from him, go ahead and play him. Carmelo, 5-4, not for me. Sadiq Bey, because he's starting, he's okay. PJ Tucker at 3,900, he's not in play with everybody starting. Covington at 3,800, he could be in play. Last man in type situation. Josh Jackson, I don't know what to tell you about Josh Jackson. Because they might get blown out. Is he coming off the bench? He might be viable. If he's starting, they get blown out, he might get benched. So I might just stay away from Josh Jackson. Jokic, 11-4, play him. So 4-game slate, you'll need the raw points. AD, same thing. Bam, 8,500 against Detroit, good play. Are they gonna get their full rotations? Is the game gonna be close? That's the question you gotta ask yourself. Nurkic, I don't like his minutes, not in play for me. Zubac in play. He's expected to play 24 minutes. The thing with Zubac, that he's a 1.1 fantasy point per minute player. So you got to keep in mind, keep that in mind when you're rostering him. That means that he is a good play. So he averages 25 points. His salary is $5,100, and I have a projected for 25 fantasy points. So what you see is what you get from him. Nerlens Noel, they'll need him against the Lakers, especially if they start Jordan. So I'll say Nerlens Noel's in play, and I'll update him in my chart. I wasn't even thinking about him when I was making the chart, but he is in play. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start with Jokic. I want Cunningham. I don't know how we're gonna play everybody, but let's figure it out. I want Paul George. That leaves me at 4180. Let me see something. 4280 with AD. THT 59. And then let's see something. Corey Joseph has been starting. Monte Morris. Actually, this ain't bad. So what we're gonna do? With our starting five, we're gonna pick up Monte Morris, Cunningham, Paul George, AD, THT. These are going to be placeholders until we get value. And once we get more value, figure out who's starting, then we could start. Putting people in their spots. But right now, because it's a 4-game slate, you want to try to get low salary players who are starting. You know, and they have some injuries. So Monte Morris is going to get good run at 4,400. Last four games, 35, 24, 19, and 16 fantasy points. 37, 32, 28, and 23 minutes. And the last game was a blowout, so it looks like he didn't get his full run. So that's fine. THT, you know he's going to shoot with LeBron off the court. So, and Cunningham, you know what he's going to do. So, this is how I'm going to start the lineup, and we're going to jump to FanDuel. It's been a little bit of a long video. I want to do more advanced things into this community, onto this YouTube channel, because I use a lot of things to determine who and what I'm gonna play and when I'm gonna play them. So I just wanted to share them with you also and let you know if I'm going to be offering a Patreon, then there's real things that come with it, like, you know, just the big boy league. If you're new, subscribe, hit the bell, thumbs up the video, let YouTube know that I'm trying to help you out and we're trying to win money. and I'm trying to teach you DFS. If you can do that for me, I'll keep doing this for you. Point guard on FanDuel with the pricing a lot softer. I do like Lowry. Let's do this. Let's start. No, we don't got to do that. I know what to do. All right. Let's pick up Lillard at 8-8. We're picking up Cunningham at 7-5. Paul George at 9-2. Definitely need some savings. You know what? We could play Hartenstein. Hartenstein is a good player. I'll add him. Last four games, 11.8, 32.2, 35.2, 11.9 fantasy points. They're playing Dallas. They might need him, but that's not going to be good enough for me. Because if they don't need him, then you're going to be looking at 11 fantasy points. Let's see. We're going to play Trey Lyles. You know why we're playing Trey Lyles? We're going to play Trey Lyles because Isaiah Stewart is suspended. And Kelly Olynyk is out also. And Trey Lyles is going to be the replacement for Stewart. So keep your eye on starting lineup for Detroit. Pretty sure it's going to be Trey Lyles, and you're playing him at 3,700. See how easy we find value? What did I leave us with? 6-1. That's a lot of money. So at center, we could pick whoever you like. You could take Jokic or you could take AD. I'm taking AD with no LeBron. And if we get super value, we play both Jokic and AD. But right now, I'm just taking AD. That way I'm leaving you $5,075. So you have a lot to work with. I don't like giving you my starting five and leaving you with jack shit to fill in the roster. I'm not like that. So we're going to go Lillard, Cunningham, George, Trey Lyles. That's the key here. If he's starting, that's the key. That unlocks the rest of the roster. Then you have AD. Let's jump to Super Draft, and we're going to get out of here. No, it's been pretty long. You guys are amazing. That's why I went ahead and started the graph, because, you know, I see we're getting to that point. You know, you guys watch my videos, like my videos, so now it's time for me to do a little bit more for you guys, too. So that's how it works. You scratch my back, I scratch yours. So, Super Draft, guard, Little looks amazing at a 1.2. Cunningham used to be 1.5, now he's 1.35. He's amazing for fantasy. We're going to take Tyler Hero, because even if they blow them out, Tyler Hero is a bench player, so he'll still get his run. If I'm playing Trey Lyles on FanDuel, then I should play Trey Lyles on SuperDraft. He's a 1.85, only if he starts. Don't be cute, only if he starts. Jeremy Grant is amazing for SuperDraft at a 1.45 multiplier. Bam 1.25 Bam is in play. Bam is a good play. Jimmy Butler 1.15. I'm gonna do Luka, Paul George, and then I'll do Jokic. Should I do Jokic or AD? I'll do Jokic. So we're gonna do Lillard, Cunningham, Hero, Lyles, Jeremy Grant, Paul George, and Jokic. And you could swap Jeremy Grant out for AD if you like, but that 1.45 multiplier, that goes a long way in Super Draft. Alright guys, listen, that's the end of this video. I truly appreciate you guys. If you need any more info about the Patreon, you know where to find me. Instagram, Twitter, DM me. You're new here, subscribe. That helps me out with YouTube. Like the video, that helps me out with YouTube. The video's been circulating to newer players, newer people. That helps everybody. The more like-minded DFS players we bring on the team, the better. Because we get to see things and hear things from different perspectives. That's how you build a winning culture. I'm trying to build a winning culture where we all win money every night. We're working towards that. I couldn't be more happier. Listen, I've taken enough of your time. I'm humbly grateful. Thank you guys for everything. Subscribe, like the video, please. I hope you won money tonight. Good luck with whatever you play today. And have a great day. I'll see you later. Ciao.